Hello, I'm Father Charles Irvin, a priest of the Diocese of Lansing, Michigan. We're here at St. Francis de Sales Seminary in the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Priests are found in the earliest times of our religious heritage, found all the way back to Abraham and the priest Melchizedek, the first known priest in the Jewish Testament. The book of Genesis reports that Melchizedek blessed Abraham. Psalm 110 sings of him, "You are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek." In his letter to the Hebrews, St. Paul speaks of him frequently. Melchizedek is important in our history because he is a mysterious priest who prefigures Christ. His significance is acknowledged when we celebrate Holy Mass, praying the Eucharistic prayer number one, the Roman canon, and just after the consecration, you hear the priest praying, "Look with favor on these offerings and accept them as you once accepted the gifts of your servant Abel, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the bread and wine offered by your priest Melchizedek." The interesting point about Melchizedek is that he had no known human family. He was never married, and instead of offering animal sacrifice, he offered bread and wine in sacrifice. He was totally unique. He was both a king and a priest. He was known as the King of Salem, Salem being Jerusalem. He was chosen by God to be a priest back at the time of Abraham, long before Moses and the Exodus of the Jews from Egypt, long before priests were authentically designated from among the lineal descendants of Aaron and Levi. Melchizedek, however, had no lineage. His priesthood did not come to him by human means. Coming from God, his priesthood was perpetual. He was a priest forever, the first of the priests we find in the Old Testament. Melchizedek was chosen by God and sent to Abraham, our father in faith. Likewise, our priests are chosen by God and sent to us. Being a priest, then, is not a gift we give to God. Rather, it is a gift God gives to us, a gift that is found only in Christ, our eternal high priest. The important point to bear in mind is that it is God who chooses individuals to become priests. We may choose to become teachers, or lawyers, or doctors, or become members of any number of professions. When it comes to being a priest, however, the choice is God's first. God offers, we respond. Our response is necessary, of course, but the initiative comes first of all from God. A priest is not his own. Once ordained, he belongs to God alone. He relinquishes control over his life to God in his own personal sacrifice. Realizing this, I've often thought that when I utter the words, "This is my body," I'm speaking about my own body in Christ's body, my own blood in Christ's blood. I'm acting, speaking, and living in the person of Christ. It is not my will that is being done, it is God's. It is not my will that is being done, it is God's. Please pray for priests and those whom God is calling to the priesthood of Jesus Christ.